lettering with about a number two brush. It's all got worn off. It's got good teeth marks on it though. It's got the look of a Percy Baker. Brush hair is a problem. So is paint viscosity. I got my paint too thin. So it looks like my O is going to overlap right into there. This board is Mondo slippery. I got it quite well cleared. And it is, my paint is thin and the board is slippery. And what that means is I don't have the resistance that I would like to have. So anyway, since this letter style is overlapping quite a bit, I want the overlaps to be obvious, and I do want some negative space in between it so it doesn't get too heavy. So I'm gonna fudge the pattern. Might have to double coat it. Now this T, the bottom little jag at the T, and the H have a relationship here, and that's why I'm lettering two verticals first. Yes, I need to know where that is in order to do this one right. Because I want to make this one like one feel. Thank you. get your brush just right, nice and sharp, that's a good time to go down and catch the edges. Don't try to do that on a full brush because it's just not as sharp. Kind of fight yourself on that. There's a lot of crack in this letter style. Term we use in the Parsons family. Cracklosis. I thought it was way out there. Let me move this in. Now that was a nice white, folks. Let me get much better than that. I worked with a sign painter once, no names here, but he was kind of bragging about how he never had to wipe a letter off. And as I got better, I realized he probably should have. It'd be nice if you're so good you never had to do it, but... that's not me. And I don't letter very much anymore. But it's kind of like the old bicycle. You know, you don't forget how to do it. I don't know. You can get tuned up to where it's like anything else. In it every single day, you're going to be tuned up, but I don't know if you ever forget how. And see, this gets quite a bit of overlap. I'm going to go above here so there's no doubt that we are meaning to do this. Come up through that stroke. I don't see any pattern here. Now, I found the edge, I cleaned up the right edge by pushing the brush in, you know, you see down here, you push it in and it spreads out. It's much easier sometimes to find the edge that way, by pushing it in and spreading it out than trying to move your brush right to the edge and make a point like that. So. Okay. there's the A. There's the F. It's probably right here. Some of the thinners coming out of the brush. This lowercase net F needs a blob. There's a lot of things hidden in this G. It's coming right down there. This one. Not this too. Okay, I've come back to this. I've changed my brush from a Kafka 5.0 to a 1.0. And it looks the same, but it acts a little different. And I'm liking this one better. I'm going to stay with the black. Go here. So, it's going to work out okay. This, on its edge is